So, all right. So I want to start off this call just reminding you that this is going to be as valuable to all of you as essentially it can be based on your feedback, your conversation, your input, your ahas, your questions, your suggestions. So I'll talk a little bit about myself here so you know why I'm talking to you about how to recruit yourself out of production. But more importantly, what are you going through in your business right now? What is it that you are trying to achieve? What are the biggest burning questions you have? What are your main challenges? What ahas can you bring to the group as well? This is being recorded and this is going to be sent out to all of you and those that registered, which are many more people that won't come on live but are going to watch this. So you have the opportunity to impact others by sharing ahas, suggestions, ideas, as well as asking questions. So I would love to see questions. So you see your questions portion here on your screen. Go ahead and just type those in. It doesn't have to be a question. It can be a suggestion, idea, an aha, thought, a challenge, of course, and questions as well. So please start posting those things as quickly as you can. Can I just ask a quick favor of you? Can you guys raise your hand and let me know that you can hear me? Just want to make sure that you guys are hearing everything that I'm saying as a test. Perfect. Thank you guys. Appreciate that. Just wanted to make sure before I get into the nitty gritty. So looking forward to your questions and your interaction. Please do that throughout this webinar. We have 30 minutes, you guys. 30 minutes to cover how to recruit yourself out of production is quite a challenge in and of itself. So again, I want to make sure that I'm answering the questions that you guys have along the way. So my name is Cari Heibel-Briner. I am the Director of Expansion for Hergenrother Realty Group, or Group as we're known across the country in our 23 locations. Last year, we as an entity, as a group across the country, transformed almost 1,600 lives through home ownership, and we're on pace to almost double that this year. We did over $350 million in volume. Again, that should climb dramatically, both our average sale prices, as well as our production is just increasing year over year tremendously so far. So we're blessed, to say the least. I am a former realtor. I also was a Keller Williams team leader for one of the top real estate offices of Keller Williams in the entire state of Minnesota. Actually led it to the number one office in closed transactions. And I did that by succeeding through others and really growing a large real estate team, which is a market center, and then helping to grow a bunch of small teams inside of that market center, as well as bringing a number of expansionists into our market center, really understanding the concept of team and building a business. And then when, of course, I moved over into the director of growth and now the director of expansion, that's exactly what I'm doing, is I'm succeeding through others, bringing those people into our world, partnering with them, and continuing to grow a real estate team alongside Adam that is doing almost, close to 3,000 transactions this year. So in this process, and in these last, let's call it really actually about 7 years, I've recruited over 700 people to the industry, to Keller Williams, or to her group expansion. And so we all know the answer. Talent and recruiting the right talent is what's going to push us to the next level of opportunity. And it's what's going to push us out of production and what's going to allow us to truly succeed through people. So yes, recruiting is definitely a big part of what I've been able to do. And the way you look at it, the way you think about it, and all of that, and the way that you strategically do this is important. And so we're going to talk a bit about that. Goals are cheap, you guys. The new goal is execution. We all have goals. We write them down every year, every quarter, every month, whatever the case may be. But are we actually executing? Are we actually sticking to the plan and doing what we need to do? That's the biggest question. And are we recruiting and attracting talent that's doing that? So here's the deal. You have to be ready to increase the quality of your problems if you're going to succeed through others and if you're going to truly get yourself to a place where you are no longer in production. You're more of a fifth or sixth level business owner. Here's the reality. 96% of businesses fail within the first year. That's because they set goals and they don't execute on them. It's also because they aren't willing to do what they need to do in that first year to build a foundation that can get them where they need to go. Most of you are way past your first year of business. We know you didn't fail, so congratulations. You guys are moving forward into the next level of business, and that's leadership. And maybe you've been there for a while, maybe you're just getting there, maybe you just need to continue to fundamentally work on yourself to become the person who you need to be to get there. Either way, leadership is not sexy. It sounds like it is, and everybody wants to be a leader, and quite frankly, leadership is not sexy. In fact, the leaders are the ones that have to do all the things that most people won't. And that's the reason that they get to become who they become and where they get to go, and most of that is to a place where most people won't ever end up. And it's because they push themselves through that not sexy part of leadership, and they fail forward throughout that process. So here's a question to ask yourself. If you truly want to recruit yourself out of production, you have to be training for an Ironman. When we're putting it in perspective of running, you cannot be training for a 5K if you want to do that. If you want to be a realtor, go train for a 5K. If you want to get yourself out of production, you need to start training for an Ironman. The level of the activity that you do on a daily basis has to change, or you'll never get there. So are you willing to do that? Are you mentally ready to do that? Are you physically ready to do that? That's a question that you have to answer for yourself. We'll talk a bit about that throughout this webinar. So to answer that question, you have to be ready to embrace the suck. You guys, we've talked about this all the time. Entrepreneurship is living the next few years of your life like most people won't, so that you can spend the rest of your life like few people will, right? So are you willing to do what it takes? Are you willing to become who you have to become? That is the burning question, and that is what I believe holds most people back. They say yes, but they mean no. They say yes, and subconsciously they don't want to. They say yes, and they set the goal, but they actually don't execute on it. And or when the going gets tough, they back out, and then they start getting back into production, and they don't actually move forward and push through the pain and embrace the suck during that time frame in the middle that really is the grind that isn't fun. And that's what's going to separate you from others, and that's going to get you where you need to go. I mean, truly, you guys, in building this business with Adam, the reality is that I really did have to fail forward dramatically. Moving from a team leader recruiting role and leadership role to leading and building a national organization alongside Adam was a very different thing. And so there were definite growing pains. Moving into a business that at that time was much smaller and really just on the cusp of growing, I had to be okay with a certain salary. I had to be okay working harder than I ever worked, failing forward, pushing with very little financial result because, and it's the same that, and I'm saying the story because it's the same that you have. You have to commit to a salary and stay there, and you have to reinvest it back in your business, and you have to start paying other people, and you have to start giving up your transactions and the money that normally would come to you now with a higher cost of sale. Like, all of these decisions have to be made. And it boils down to your mindset and your emotional fitness around that to be able to see the long term and to know that this time frame is necessary and you have to do what it takes if you want to get to the other side. And so that's a really important mindset piece that I believe if you take anything away from this webinar, that's it. Because we know what we need to do. We all know what we have to do. We all can do it if we really want to. We know what the goal is, and we could all execute if we want to. We could all fail forward and get better at it and start recruiting the right talent and start pushing ourselves to the next level. The problem is that a lot of us aren't mentally and emotionally fit to do that. We aren't prepared to embrace the suck to the level that we really need to. We aren't prepared to resort to a certain salary for a period of time and to potentially live beneath our means and all of those things. We're not willing to maybe let go of some of the control that we need to or some of the income that we're used to, and we're selling a lot of real estate ourselves. So that is the burning question. That is the question that I hope you all ask yourself and then commit to it or not commit to it to help you make your decision if you're ready to truly recruit yourself out of production. That's the one takeaway I hope you all can take from this particular webinar. I don't see any questions, ahas, or ideas, you guys. Don't forget to put those in the question box. I'm watching it, and I'm happy and excited to answer those questions. So please, please post some things in here. What do you want to get out of this webinar? We only have 30 minutes. In fact, we only have 20 left, and I want to make sure if there's something that you wanted to at least make sure that you had answered, we could do that. So please post away. You guys know this. You've heard Gary Keller say it. Adam says it all the time. We've seen people do it. I'm seeing people in my world that where this is happening. You are only, and in my own life, you are only 5 years away from anywhere you want to be, you guys. That's it. 5 years. But you have to embrace the suck. You have to be emotionally and mentally fit and prepared. You have to be prepared to go through the grind, and you have to fully commit to the execution of your goals. So How do you do that? Well, first of all, you have to build a platform for success. And so you can see in the diagram here, there's money and there's time, right? The grind is going to take you 5 to 7 years, okay? It truly is. And then you're going to be able to, one second. I hope you guys can still see my webcam. It was saying that there were some issues, but I'm hoping that that's working. Okay. If it's not, you guys, please post the question and let me know if you can't see my screen. Something just popped up and said that they weren't sharing it, but it looks like it's sharing. So that might have been a technical difficulty. So as you can see on the screen here, hopefully you can see on the screen here, the reality is that the company has to invest in platforms, systems, people, and failing forward for a 5 to 7 year period of time while still grinding away at the real estate sales in order to get where they need to get in order to see the hockey stick grow. And that is what happens. It is a grind, and it actually dips down, as you notice, before it starts to come back up. You started and you were making some money here. You had some time here and you were selling a lot of real estate and everything was going okay. And you decided to build this business and do this business thing and this team thing. And it started to go down before it went back up. And that's because you now have to focus on three things. You have to make money through selling real estate, continuing to build that brand and that platform through real estate sales. You need to build the platform and invest in the platform, the systems and the people. You have to fail forward through all of that process. And you need to start recruiting talent to the platform. It takes time, people. It takes time. It takes money. And it takes a lot of hard work and grind, a lot of emotional and mental fitness. This is when you're training for the Ironman. Somebody who's training for a 5K can't handle this. It doesn't work. So this is the time frame that you need to invest in. Now, some of you will say, okay, sweet, I've already been in this for 2, 3, 4 years. Hopefully I'm coming on the upswing soon. And I'll tell you, it really is that 5 to 7 years. I've talked to so many people. Adam has talked to so many people. We talk to Gary all the time. The reality is that 5 to 7 years, it is extremely consistent. So wherever you are, just know that's the amount of time that you have. Just focus on it. You know, just continue through it. Don't give up now. If you're halfway through it, God, don't give up now. You're almost there, right? And you will start to see that hockey stick come to reality for you as well. But that is the reality of what you need to be prepared for if you're just starting this process. Here's your path to freedom. I mean, the way we look at it is ultimately you want to become the chairman of the board, right? That's you. You want to become that CEO, and you need to become that CEO of your business first. Maybe you are the director of sales and you're not selling anymore. And then eventually you hire that person and you replace yourself and you stay CEO and chairman of the board. The reality is that you have to get some pretty talented people in your world though in the meantime. So director of listings and director of buyers, or a director of sales that does both, that also sells. That's an option as well. A lot of our teams do that because their agents are both doing buyers and sellers. And of course, a director of operations. I mean, these are your three key people. Here's the trick, you guys. You have to go find people that are talented enough to rise into these locations and into these opportunities and are willing to come in as an agent or a transaction coordinator for a period of time to earn the right as the team and the opportunity grows to move into that next director of sales or director of listings or director of buyers and director of ops. Does that make sense? So you need to be able to have the vision and the passion for what you're doing and where you're going. And the leadership in order to attract those people so that they come into your world at that more entry level and that they're willing to stay there just long enough until they get that next opportunity. Because most of the time, you can't just go in there and bring those people in at that role because number one, you don't even have maybe the team, the structure, the people, the transactions for those people to really be at that high level yet. But you need them to create that foundation alongside of you to help you to build that business. And then they can move into those roles as you build that business together. So think of it that way. So who are you talking to? Who are you recruiting? Do not recruit for who you need today. Recruit for the future. But then how do you go and find those right people and you sell your vision and sell your opportunity to them and help them to come alongside you, meet them where they're at, but show them the opportunity? Here's the thing. It's going to put pressure on you because you need to go and build that team. If you bring those people in just long enough to stay in that agent role to move into that next opportunity, you better be pushing your business forward so that opportunity is tangible for them. If they don't see it and it's not going to be their reality for 5 to 10 years, are they going to hang in there with you? Maybe not. Right. So this is going to push you and hold you accountable to the growth when you can find those people. That's why you want to hire for or recruit for the future, not today, because that's what's going to push you to get where you need to go. So the phase one, and most of you are here or past here, is that you have to prove production. So success has to come because you are so, growth has to come because you're so successful that you need to grow, not the other way around. If you don't have your own production, don't go grow a business because the business isn't going to replace your production. You have to have validity. You have to have gone through this to earn your right to get to that next phase, right? That's why lottery winners have such a high rate of bankruptcy and challenges, financial challenges after they win the lottery. It's because they didn't earn the right to that money. They just got it. It just came to them. And when that happens, they typically don't know how to handle it. We all need to earn our right to where we're going, both financially and just leadership wise. So we have to prove the production ourselves first. And most of you are there past that. Now it's the next phase, which is phase two, which is the grind. There's no other way to put it. This is embracing the suck. This is where you need to build a business. You need to become a leader. You need to continue to sell real estate. You need to attract talent. You need to do it all. And you need to make sure that you have the emotional fitness and that you're training for the Ironman during this process so that you can earn the right to phase three, right? Which is when your employees employ you and you truly are at that sixth, seventh level, fifth level in some cases, but you are owning a business and you're truly recruiting yourself out of production and you are succeeding through others. So we talked about this, proving production, focus on increased listings, increased productivity, making peace with your salary. This is important. You sell as much real estate as you possibly can, and then you make peace with a very conservative salary, and you know this is where you're going to stay until you earn the right to, and people are actually in your world that they are employing you and you're making the money that you want to make long term. So you have to save the money to invest back in your business and the growth of your business in the people and the systems, because that phase two isn't going to work if you don't do this. So sell as much real estate as possible. Take as little away from that business as possible for your own income. Make peace with that and make sure that you're reinvesting in your business in the right people, in the right systems, the right talent, the right platform. And this is the grind, phase two. You have to still maintain that production. You have to still build a platform for growth. You have to invest in the right people, and you have to work every single day on yourself to become a better leader. It's a lot of jobs, right? And it's possible. So here's the thing, is you have to be strategic about that. So when you maintain your production, don't go out with buyers anymore. Please don't do that. Work with listings only and make sure that you're in the right people that you have are truly leveraging you to the highest level possible so that you can maintain a very high level of production and that you do as little work as possible. So that's the first test of this right person in that leadership or director of ops role, showing them this is what you need to help me do right now so that we can get to phase three together. And that's opening up a door of opportunity for you just like it is for me. So let's do this together. You on the ops side and me on the sales side, the business growth side. Let's do this together. So you have to commit to something every single day that is working on yourself to become a better leader. You guys cannot get to the next level if you don't become who you need to become to go there. That does, it just doesn't work. You have to invest in the right people. So are you looking for the right talent? Are you sharing the vision? Are you bringing those people in just long enough, you guys, until they can take that next opportunity? And are you succeeding through them? So when you maintain that level of production, you decide that you're only doing listings. Who are you giving those buyers to? Go find a very talented person that you know could ultimately potentially become your leader of buyers or your leader of listings or your director of sales, and start throwing them your sphere of influence and all of the other buyer opportunities that you have. Give them that opportunity while they bring opportunities to the team and grow with them and succeed through them, because that's how you leverage your time, how you start that first level of succeeding through others, and how you are building that opportunity for the right people to come up alongside you, along with, of course, your executive admin that's going to come in to earn the right to become director of operations, etc. So together, the three of you, the core of you, need to continue to move this ship forward. All of you helping in that recruiting and attracting of talent, all of you producing, all of you building a platform together and being willing to do this for your next opportunities. The biggest one people don't do is working every day to become a better leader. And that is something that you have to commit to and you have to spend time on and you have to time block it. When we get busy hiring, leading the people, recruiting, building the platform, maintaining our production, it's the one thing that we let slide. And if this link is missing, you're never going to get to the next level, even if all the rest of this is right. So don't leave that one off your calendar. All right. And that's where you need to, and I'm going to elaborate a bit more in terms of the models and the systems. So when you're at this point, now how do you share your opportunity? How do you share your vision? Well, first of all, you have to have models and systems. You have to know what those are, and you have to be able to articulate them, because that's how you're going to be able to recruit people to this opportunity. So what is the growth trajectory for your business? With your vision the way it is, how do people move their way up in your world? When you can be pushed out of the lead listing agent, when you can be pushed out of the director of sales, when you can be pushed out of CEO, and you can be pushed out of that growth leader role, you want to be pushed out of those things, because that lets you go and open up opportunities for yourself in other places, and it allows success to rise up in your organization. How do they push you out of that? What are those requirements? What is that opportunity for them? And then overarchingly, as an organization, what is your mission? What is your vision? What is your value proposition? You have to know that. Fundamentally, if you don't know these things, you can't do any of the other things we're talking about. And so this is critical. Spend time on this if you haven't yet. And then when you're building that platform, right, you have to build that during this time frame with systems and structure in order to be able to go continue to recruit talent to it. So we know this, there's no secret sauce, there's no magic pill. Find what works for you and your business and has the best ROI. And what works for you and your business isn't going to work for somebody else. So don't compare yourself to others. Just figure out what you're doing well already. Do better, do more of it. Find better systems, accountability, structure around the automation, and continue to find what works best for you, your business, and has the best ROI. So you have to spend time, along with your director of operations, looking at these things all the time to be able to be making these decisions. So what is your lead generation platform? What is your CRM? Do you have the right accounting software as your team grows? Do you have the right transaction management systems, checklists, tools, automation? Do you have showing services? Do you have auto dialers? Do you have graphic designers and marketing people? Do you have social media help? Do you have recruiting and hiring systems? Do you understand the CV process? All of those things are going to be critical. On the structure side of things, you guys, talent wants to be accountable. They want to be learning all the time. Talent is accountable. That is a mindset, by the way, and talent is learning-based. So if you don't create a cadence of accountability and culture of learning and growing in your organization, you're not going to recruit the level of talent that you want to. Do you have daily scorecards for your agents? Do you have weekly meetings on your wildly important goals? Do you have quarterly reviews? Do you have team meetings? Do you have trainings? Do you have masterminds, right? Do you have team events? What is it? Do you have some kind of place where they can track their appointments and their conversions? This is going to be critical. What do you need to do? First of all, you guys, you have to hold yourself accountable to these things. If you don't, it's going to be hard to hold somebody else accountable to it. But work together with those talented people in that core of your business that you have right now, director, future director of ops, future director of sales, or lead agent. Look to those people. Find what works for them. Find what they like and start to create a structure and system around this, so that as you start to recruit more and more people to it, you can actually have success in that. Because if people come into your world and none of this is existing and it's all really kind of willy-nilly and constantly being changed, now look, it's constantly going to need to be revised, and you can make those revisions and you can keep making things better based on the ideas and the suggestions of your agents. I highly recommend that. That makes them vested in this partnership when they can be heard and they have the opportunity to share. But at the end of the day, it shouldn't be changing CRMs and changing systems and all of these things constantly when you're starting to truly grow a big team, because that is going to be a challenge for you. So, make sure that you've got the foundation there. Making tweaks to it and changing is always going to be the reality, but you need to have these things in place to some degree to be able to go and grow a larger team around it. I love it. So how do we get it done, prioritize, and the plan needs to be visible? How? So great questions, Bob. So as far as priority goes, to be honest with you, depending upon how your team looks right now, you should hopefully know what the priorities for you, your personal business, and those people that are in your world right now. So is it that they need better conversions? Do they need to be talking to more people? Is there need to be more automation? Do we need to leverage more? Those are the things that we need to ask ourselves, because that's going to lead us to priorities. The number one priority is to make sure that you and any other agents on your team that are talent or just in general have the best systems to be automated, to be efficient in their lead generation, to be able to talk to as many people, to be able to have the most leverage possible on the transaction coordination, listing management, and marketing side. So that has to be your platform priority first and foremost. Secondarily, how are you even taking that to the next level with your leverage, because you now need to do all of these other things. And then you need to move more into the structure side of things, the scorecards, the accountability, the meetings, and of course, then the recruiting and hiring as you continue to build this business. So daily versus longer term, absolutely, working in versus on the business, of course. So I would say right now, what we like to do is we'll say, for our Rainmaker, for example, 3 to 4 days out of the week in the morning, their lead generation is still for business. But they're leveraging as much of that as possible. So they're going out there and they're able to do those appointments in a much lower, less part of time. So 1 to 2 days a week, they're actually recruiting during that lead generation time. And then in the afternoons, if you can just go on appointments and hand everything else off of your listings and let other people do it, you've now freed up time in your afternoons that you normally would be doing those things, where you can now go and invest a little bit more in working on the business. So, and then just this page right in front of you right now, take a picture of this and literally use this as a check mark. Can you, these things on this board right here on this screen right now, do you have all these things? Do you need to revise them? Do you need to look for a better platform, a better structure to this? Just use this as your accountability for now, because this would be a great start. You can always add to this. So hopefully that answered those questions. And recruiting talent is always the biggest challenge for everyone. I'll get into that here in a second, and we'll talk more about it. I also have another webinar a little bit more about recruiting as well that you guys could certainly join in. So watch for more information on that. The reality is that you have three focuses. These should become your only three habits. It's the only thing that matters daily, and that is lead generation and production. And we like to see about 5 pendings per month from the Rainmaker on average. Again, focus on listings. Agent accountability through numbers to increase the team production, so the current agents that you have, and then recruiting more talent to continue to build wealth. Those are the only things that you should focus on. So everything else should be done by somebody else. The launching of the new agents, the transitioning them into the team, the listing management, the transaction coordination, the lead generation, marketing and conversion, and the recruiting system. You need to find people that help you with this. So does your level of talent right now on the operations side, and maybe even in the director of sales side or lead agent side, how can they help you with this? What can you leverage? Because if you need to focus on your three habits, the rest of these things need to be getting done, but they need to be getting done by somebody else. So prioritize those things. This would be a great screen for you to take a snapshot of as well. And this is what gets you to phase 3, which is freedom, where your employees actually employ you. You are the CEO, and you just continue to work on the culture, the experience, and the opportunity for others. You invest time and money into yourself and your other leaders, and that becomes your full-time job. Exciting, right? Because we can all get here if we continue to go through the things that we have to go through. Okay, so the platform, X factor, people. So Bob, to your point, it's the biggest challenge. It's also the X factor. It's the most important thing. You guys, you don't build a business. You build people, and then people build a business. So who are the people that you can attract? Who are the people you're in business with? You have to bring smart, driven, talented people into your world, and they won't come into your world unless you work on yourself and you're somebody that they want to be in business with, and your vision matters and it aligns with theirs. People are the X factor who are going to implement your platform and ultimately drive it forward. So your platform is what's going to differentiate your business from others. You are going to be able to attract the right people because they can see it as a foundation to their own success. So it has to be the platform and the other people you surround yourself with, and it has to be you as a leader. Those are the things that you have to work on right now in order to be able to attract the right people. So you have to become who you need to become. The best way to recruit talent, you guys, is to be talent. So what are those areas you need to improve in yourself if you're struggling with recruiting talent? People want to work with successful, driven people. Are you that person right now? Are you being that person? Talent wants to be pushed. They want to be held accountable. So you need to show people that you hold yourself to a high level of accountability and that you push yourself, because that's what's going to attract talent. Does that make sense? You have to lead by example. To be a leader, you have to be able to lead yourself at a high level first. And people see that. people want to be around you when you're motivational, you're inspirational, but you're also driven and you're successful because they know that you're pushing yourself to that next level. Put yourself out there and show people. And lastly, one that I really want to talk more about is to come from contribution and truly want to succeed through others. You guys, if you truly do not want to help other people be successful, building a business isn't for you. Ultimately, you're not going to be able to succeed through others if you don't have this true desire to see other people succeed. So you have to be doing this for the right reasons. Ultimately, you guys, you are going to attract talent through your actions, not your words. So what are you doing to come from contribution every single day? What are you doing to lead yourself and to grow yourself every single day? Well, your mindset matters in this. Are you training yourself to look for talent every single place that you go right now? Are you still in that mode of looking for real estate transactions, right? You should always be recruiting. You have to flip your mindset. Make sure you have that elevator speech ready. This is your mission and your vision statement and truly your passion around how people can come into your world and be better because of it. Connect, converse, share and ask on social media and in mastermind groups and by coaching and training other people. Remember, you guys, this is one that I learned a long time ago. If you don't ask, you surely aren't going to get it. So ask for what you want, not only asking the universe, but ask people, talk to people, share your vision, put things out there, hold yourself to the highest level of accountability to make sure that this happens. And remember, you're always building a bench of talent and you always are top grading. No matter where your business is today, you are always top grading. So don't force growth. Allow the success in your business to force the rest of the business to grow. That's a big mistake people make. All right. I know that you guys want to hear more about recruiting. I'm sure you do. It's the burning question. It's the hardest one, but when you nail it, you guys, it becomes amazing. And I'm here to tell you, if you can get that one or those two people that are real big talent, they will help you to continue to find more talent like them. So just go find your first amazing talent and it's going to change your business forever. And speaking of that, I just wanted to let you guys know there are some upcoming trainings and events. So if you're interested in how you work with your director of operations, communication strategies for founders and force multipliers, that's Adam and Hallie's book, by the way. What's the difference between an executive assistant and a chief of staff as you're growing your business bigger? Branding 101, which is phenomenal. We've talked a little bit about this. If you still need to define your mission, vision, and values, that would be a great one. Limitless, which is just an overall mindset of one of our CEOs who is growing a big business and getting himself out of production. How to build wealth through real estate. And of course, the four-week webinar series on the founder and the force multiplier. All of this can be found at adamhergenrother.com/events to register. So make sure you take a look at that. Lastly, for those of you that have said you want to connect with me a little bit more, or maybe are just thinking about that, I do have an opportunity to do coaching. I have a coaching program where it is one-on-one coaching calls, four of them per month. I actually added something where there's two per month for those of you that maybe don't need this weekly but want it twice a month. Some great top love and accountability when it comes to recruiting. You can pick my brain more on the recruiting part of the business, but also just general business building if you've thought about expansion. How you recruit yourself out of production, how you compensate people, how you kind of strategize. All of that is encompassed in my one-on-one coaching calls. I do have a few spots left, so email me to learn more about this, Cari@hergroup.com, or you can give me a call or send me a text. Find me on Facebook and friend request me as well. Would love to connect with you. I do a first call with you to just share with you what that's going to be like. You guys, you can meet me. We can do a one-on-one, 20-minute just introductory free call. Typically, it's a video call, and then we can decide if this one-on-one coaching might be for you where you're at in your business. So please reach out to me. I want to give you as much value as I can, both in these webinars, but also in person if you need to take your recruiting and your business building to the next level. So thanks so much, you guys, for joining me and hanging in there for just a couple minutes longer. If you need anything outside of any of the stuff we've talked about, feel free to email me as well, Cari@hergroup.com. Happy to answer any questions I can. Thanks so much, you guys. Make it an awesome rest of your day, and I look forward to connecting with many of you soon.